Sorry. This is actually a really bad idea.
You know what I thought? I came home from practice. I thought we'd been robbed. Actually called the cops.
I'm sorry, Tom. I wrote you a note and, and I tore it up.
Ashley Hassel.
Oh, sorry, Suni. This is Tom. Suni thinks her daughter might be caught up in prostitution. Anyway, she wrote this card, and I figured that since you're the ex-poster, you might be able to figure out where it was posted from.
Nothing to tell. South. Somewhere south. Nail it down to a few post offices. So how are you?
Good. You?
Okay. Seeing anyone?
Gabby's trying to organise my life.
Lucky you.
Can you do me one more favour? Can you make a phone call?
All hail our new head of comedy. We're all thrilled to have you here, Dick. Thrilled.
Well, it's good to be back. Reunite the old team.
Yes, little Dick has come a long way. Hey, Dick. Dickhead.
It's always champagne comedy with you, isn't it, Gray? Look, I just came down to tell you that if there's anything I can do for you, please call.
What could you possibly do for me?
You have had several obscenity warnings from the Standards Commission.
Yes, I did get your memo on that, Dick. Very, very interesting.
Look, I think that you are the greatest comedy talent this country has ever seen.
Yes.
But the political diatribes, the pointless smut, the nastiness, just puts people off.
Are you threatening me, Dick?
Not at all. I'm just saying that a pissing dog is one thing, but there are limits. Frank's not running things anymore. Kerry is. Things have changed.
What happened to the young writer with dreams of changing comedy?
I had kids.
Well done. You bred.
If Colin was here, he would tell you exactly the same thing.
Richard, my boy.
We're back with the
Graham
Kennedy Show. Still to come, Bert's Wheel and special guest Barry Crocker. But now, here's Graham.
I don't want to make some lame excuse. It happened, Kel. It just kind of happened.
Who was she?
Rachel.
Rachel.
Fucking hell.
I can't do this anymore.
Neither can I.
I don't want to see you anymore. I don't want you to talk to me. I just want to hate you so I can walk away from you.
No, Kel.
Say nothing. Just stop and leave me alone.
Kel, I want to explain. I let it happen. Maybe because I couldn't take us anymore.
Doesn't matter now.
I do love you, Kel.
I love you, but it doesn't help, does it?
No.
It just makes it worse.
Floyd, everything work out last night?
He paid me, Larry. Thanks for the job.
Fuck it, Johnny. Keep your lady happy. Well, what can I do you for?
You heard about the missing kid.
A parent's worst fear.
Well, while we were up at the Marston house making the delivery, I looked in the back of the new owner's car. I saw a plastic bag in the back seat. It was leaking.
Was it little boy-sized?
It was head size.
The new owner is Richard Straker. You think he killed the missing Glick boy and kept the head?
No, I'm not saying all that.
Imagine what that would do to his antique business.
The bag was leaking all over the leather seats.
Did you tell Mike what you saw?
No, I didn't think much of it at the time. Until today.
So why tell me? Go tell Parkins Gillespie if you think it's important.
I'm telling you because you know the guy.
Relax, Floyd. Straker called me this morning, excited about tackle and shacks. seems he tried his hand at ice fishing and finds it relaxing.
Ice fishing?
Maybe he bagged a tuna or a cod, whatever you swamp Yankees pull out of these lakes.
Ice fishing? Well, that's a relief. I was driving myself crazy.
I understand. But we have to be careful, Floyd. Loose talk can ruin people. My first suspect was the other new guy in town, some hotshot writer.
What writer?
Mears. He's nice enough, but a city guy, a bit abrasive, you know?
Ben Mears. I know I've been. I better get back to work.
Hey, thanks for last night. And thanks for coming to me first on this.
Bishop's Lake. That's the best spot for ice fishing.
I'll tell Straker. You're on my short list, buddy.